Well, you know what? It could be. I think people are mistaking your radio station's phone number for the hotline to call to complain about potholes.
Yes, the Pothole Peters, as Scott Peters is being called by you. He doesn't love potholes, infrastructure problems, does he, Carl? Isn't that just campaign rhetoric?
Well, you know, he hasn't made road maintenance and repairs a priority. In fact, when you take a look at his record on the city council, he presided over a massive slashing of our infrastructure funds and really neglected our basic road maintenance. And where did the money go? It went right into the pension system. This was a city council that was negligent in how it managed our finances, and even more negligent when it came to our roads. And because they skipped so many road resurfacing projects, San Diego's roads went from being relatively decent in 2000 to being the seventh worst roads in the country by the time that Scott Peters left office.
So where's that money been going, Carl DeMille? Because it's not like we're spending zero. They do budget things. Other places around the country budget millions for snow removal, for example. And we have money there. With same thing for water mains if they burst. There's not exactly a trust fund for this, I take it?
No, in fact, that's been the problem. Scott Peters raided the infrastructure funds. And instead of keeping a schedule, a proper funding schedule for basic maintenance of the roads and replacement of roads, he raided those funds along with his council colleagues, and they put the money into government pensions. And this is, you know, again, now we're seeing the consequence. If you don't maintain a road, it starts falling apart past the point of basic maintenance. It then has to be replaced, which is far more expensive. Think about it as changing the oil in your car. If you skip your oil changes time after time, you may save a little money along the way, may be able to go out and have a little fun, but guess what? It catches up with you, and your car is going to completely break down. That's what's happened to our roads. There's a reason why the potholes are out there, and that reason has been bad policies by council members, in particular Scott Peters.
Carl DeMille with us. As we move forward on this, obviously, and you've talked about this before on the water mains that blow, and we seem to have a new one going every week. We've got hundreds of miles of that under the pavement of the city of San Diego. And I guess it's just pay as you go, pay as it blows now. Is that what happens?
Well, it's all interrelated. When I talk about infrastructure, not all by talking about the street resurfacing.
It's bridges. It's the whole bunch, right?
And, you know, here's the thing. When you have a government union boss in your office demanding a salary increase or bonuses or higher pensions, they get the attention. You know, a broken road or a pipe doesn't walk into your office and say, "Hey, Scott Peters, I am 100 years old and it's time to replace me." They don't have some
talking pipes. That would be something. I'd watch that.
And then, by the way, Mark, and here's the real game here, the political game. When the potholes do come and when the pipes do burst, then the politicians say, "Oh, my goodness, we don't have enough money. Can you give us a tax increase?" And this is the sort of baloney that has been happening year after year after year. It's something that when I was on the council, we said, absolutely not. We need to fix the wasteful spending, the pension giveaways. And in the water department, you and I talked at length about over $90 million in bonuses that were given out that had no justification, according to outside auditors. And that's a program that I was able to put a stop to.